Welcome back to Arise Entertainment 360.
Yes, we are back, and I've stopped laughing, thank goodness. Now, ladies, this one's for you. If you've ever wanted to be a fly on the wall in your man's man cave, then pay attention.
No, 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 wait a minute. This show and this segment is for the men.
What? This show is not for the men.
No, this segment of the show, and then his show, not our show, his show, because our next guest is no stranger to bringing entertainment, politics, and social issues to the consciousness of his viewers. And this time, he's doing it on BET's new show, Mancave.
Yes.
Jeff Johnson, welcome to the show.
Hey, how are y'all doing?
Hello.
Thanks for having me.
I mean, I feel quite excluded from this.
You should not.
Why
because,
is it called
Mancave? Shannon's
why can't
wrong?
You call it? Oh, see, thank you. Okay,
but it's called Mancave.
He's wrong.
Because it's our sacred area.
So the sacredness is not just for us.
Okay.
The sacredness is for sisters to be flies on the wall into our sacredness.
So they can understand us and why we are the way we are. Is that
so they can listen, so they can understand, so they can experience, so they can engage.
Wonderful. Oh,
yes. I guess you can watch the show.
You're canceled.
Don't tell my wife. I don't want her to watch.
Yes.
I don't want her to know.
Are you going to expose all of these manly secrets that we've always wanted to know?
You know what the goal is? When was the last time you saw black men having conversation on TV that wasn't about sports or politics?
I don't know if I have.
And that's the point, right? So
yeah,
we weren't seeing ourselves. We weren't seeing ourselves in a complex way. And so this 30 minutes is about how can we be funny, inspiring, horrifying, terrible, brilliant, all at the same time, and really give both men and women an insight on the complexity of who we are as men.
I love that you're doing it with a little help from other people. Tell us about the other cast.
Oh, no, the cast is incredible.
Yeah.
So Tank of R&B fame is a cast member. My man Cosign, who is a producer, has worked with everybody in the game. And then Slink, a.k.a. Black Jesus, is also a member of the cast. It's incredible. It was like putting together a really dope quartet.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't looking for who are a bunch of A-listers, because one, A-listers aren't always transparent, and the value of the man cave is not just authenticity, but how can we be transparent about the stuff that we're talking about? So I love the cast. It's incredible. If you've seen the show, I believe, we have a great time.
Yeah,
and the format's really different to other late night talk shows. Mm-hmm. Why?
Well, we didn't want to do a talk show. We wanted to do a talk series. And so there's no studio audience, because the moment an audience claps for somebody, then everybody's performing.
Right.
We didn't want performances. We wanted conversation. Mm-hmm. And so whether we're talking about the most mundane, silly thing, or whether we are dealing with confessions, or we're talking about, you know, mistakes that we've made or things that we've gone through, the goal is how can we just be brothers in a conversation versus trying to perform for anybody? And that's really what makes it work. And that's what's great for our guests. So, I mean, you all know it in journalism. So often, guests either want to come on or don't want to come on because folks are worried about, are y'all going to try to do the got you moment?
Right, right.
We don't do got you moments.
Yeah.
We create a space for you to feel comfortable to talk about what you want to talk about, and that's what works for our guests, and that's what makes Man Cave different.
And it's comfortable to watch. I felt like I want to be there on the couch. It was a great conversation, and I said, but, you know, it's sometimes scary because it seems like nothing is off limits to y'all.
Oh, zero.
Do the producers ever say, yeah, you can't go there, or maybe y'all shouldn't approach it that way? Like,
do the producers say that?
Or anybody ever try to hold y'all back because it seems like nothing's off limits?
They try.
Y'all go
they
there.
They try, but they fail.
Right,
they
right.
But you can tell, number one, one of the things that's great about this is we were able to negotiate several TVMA rating opportunities.
Okay.
So it's no whole. The other night, somebody was watching, they were tweeting, it's like, I didn't know you could say that on TV.
Mm-hmm. Curse words.
Like all the curse words.
Body parts.
So but it was great. But so whether it was Charlamagne coming on talking about body parts, or whether it was Fabulous talking about what he's dealing with, it's incredible. There is not a show that's ever been on TV like this before.
Wow.
Not at all.
Yeah. If you were to pick your ideal guest, your dream guest, who would that be and why? Past, present, future.
Past, present, future.
Yeah.
Wow. Past, present, future. So living I have
dead.
To go with, I have to go with Obama.
Yes,
simply because I just think so many people want to see him in the man cave.
Yes.
He's already chill in the Oval Office.
Have you seen
in the man
bed?
Cave. It's fake.
I mean,
it's fake.
It's fake. Oh.
No, that was fake. it looked great, but it was fake.
Right.
It was fake. No, but I think so many people would just be interested in what he had to say as a regular brother versus as president of the United States. Past, I would love, so I don't want to get too serious. So past, I would probably say it would be incredible to have somebody like Malcolm. Mm.
Wow.
Who could just talk not only about his life, but his death and give incredible, like having Malcolm X on Man Cave the week before Black Panther would be like the dopest TV in the history of TV.
You would shut down TV, literally. I mean, it would just erupt. That's phenomenal stuff. Yeah. So what direction are you looking to take the Man Cave in?
We want to, so a lot of people have talked about how they think the show is too short. They want to see it longer, which is great. Like, that's a great problem to have.
A two-hour show.
That's a great problem to have. We want to perfect it. And so we've got a lot of segments. So, you know, we got a segment called On My Mama, which is
what
where.
What does that entail?
So where you say, On My Mama, I've never, and then if you've ever done it, you got to drink.
Never have I ever.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So we've got another segment called Confessions that's a little bit more serious, where we dive deeper into things that we've gone through and things that we've experienced. We got Oh Hell No, where we go into the news and say, this can't believe this happened, but it actually did.
Yeah.
And so in, you know, five episodes in, we're perfecting these segments and finding a way to bring the audience a lot of fun, but still go deep in the conversation as much as we can in 30 minutes on BET. And that is what the most fun about this show is. Yeah. And what I'm loving is that we're hearing women saying, yo, I'm watching this with my husband. I had a brother hit me and was like, yo, you have no idea how much Man Cave helped me. My wife didn't believe that this is how we really are, and now she does. And so the fly on the wall piece is as important to us as giving brothers a space to have their space.
And it probably acts as a great catalyst to give them an opportunity to speak with their other significant other, so they can have these conversations that they otherwise would not know how to address with their wife or their girlfriend and stuff like that.
And while that's important, I mean, I think the most important thing is that Black men so often don't talk. Right. And so, like, we have boys and still won't be transparent.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it leads to issues of health issues, stress, anger, so on and so forth. And so we want to give an example of how can we be transparent with each other and give brothers the permission to say, listen, what actually makes me stronger is having a core group of brothers that I can be my true, honest self with.
So and be important. Vulnerable in front of as well. That's real strength.
Yeah.
So on the subject of real strength, because we all know that females are the strongest sex, would you ever let a woman in the man cave?
It depends which woman.
So we've
actually talked about it. Like, there are brothers who women just love.
Right.
And they're the kind of women who they wanted the guys. And so we're thinking about it.
I think it'll
be great at some point, but we can't have sisters come into the man cave when we haven't yet solidified the power of the man cave for men.
True.
Because y'all got a lot of shows. There's a lot of shows for women. There's a lot of shows
for
women.
Give some space for the guys. And speaking of the guys, Steve Harvey's also an EP on the show.
Yes.
So how involved is he or was he in the making of the show?
I mean, to be honest, if it wasn't for Steve, I don't know if we'd have the show. Because I think Steve's gravitas was what really attracted BET in the beginning to be interested in the show. Steve might be the hardest working person in showbiz.
Well, he has like 30 jobs.
And so
he's got
there are members of his production team that are a part of our team. So he knows what's going on. But by and large, Steve is really, you know, giving this over to the team that we have on a daily basis, making
that's
it
great.
Work. So we're gonna have him on the show at some point before the season is over.
That's gonna be hot.
And he had us on his show.
Yeah.
Just make sure he doesn't read the wrong thing.
Oh, see, there you
terrible
go.
Joke. Well, terrible joke. Yeah. But speaking of comedians and jokes, you are also an incredibly hardworking person in show business because you have a bajillion jobs, and one of them is appearing on Rickey Smiley's radio show.
I do.
What's
every
it
Tuesday
like working
Thursday
with him?
Fantastic. I mean, Rickey and I ran into each other one day. I was speaking somewhere, and all of a sudden, 15 minutes into the speech, Ricky's pulled up a chair, stage left, and is listening to my speech, taking notes. And when I got done with the speech, Rickey came back out on stage. I'm back in the dressing room. They're like, you got to go back out. Ricky's been talking about you for the last 10 minutes. And at that point, he said, man, I love you, your energy. I want you to come on my show. And the next week, he invited me on the show. That was 5 years ago. And so every Tuesday and Thursday, I'm in this madhouse known as the Rickey Smiley Morning Show,
right.
Talking to his 8 million plus listeners about the three things you need to know. And he and Brad and Gary and the whole team have been incredible. It's a great opportunity to speak to 8 million people every Tuesday and Thursday about what's going on.
And you definitely have stuff going on, because not only are you doing all that, I guess you don't have enough jobs, because you're also a managing principal at JJ. Is it JIJ?
JIJ.
JIJ Communications. What does the firm do?
So we do strategic communications. We do strategy, content development, message creation, Fortune 1, Fortune 5, municipalities, entertainers. So we help at the highest level people craft their message. We help them develop content for that message, and we help them disseminate that message in ways that increases their bottom line or increases social impact. So it's great when you've been able to be on air, but you recognize other people's messages are sometimes more important and more impactful than yours. And so I'm able to have greater impact helping the companies and the cities and the entertainers who I help do messaging than I am just trying to be the one. Because the work that we do, the work that I care about, is how do we create impact in the communities we care about? And we do that by developing a sophisticated ecosystem of folks that create impact. And that's what my company allows me to do.
Wow,
that's
you're
amazing.
Doing a great
Not
job.
Just a pretty face, huh? Now, before you go, we have to flip the script on you.
Flip it.
We're going to do a Man Cave segment of our own.
Let's do it.
Yes.
It's called, you might have heard of it, All In.
Yes. One of my favorite sets.
So this is where we give you two options, and you have to pick one of them to be all in.
I know.
That we're explaining.
For the people at home. For the people at home, because we stole it from his show, right? Okay, so we'll start off with, which one are you all in on? Fried chicken or baked chicken?
Fried chicken.
Hennessy or Ciroc?
Neither.
Okay.
I'm not a Hennessy dude.
What are you?
Some scotch.
Sophisticated drink.
When I'm doing my boozy ratchet.
He's a gentleman.
Boozy ratchet. Boozy ratchet. Okay.
So
this one I stole from his show. Beyonce or Rihanna?
That's difficult.
Rihanna.
Even I can't pick. Tell me why.
Because I'm a freak.
You asked all in.
Okay, moving on. Coming to America or The Wiz?
Oh, that's so
Coming
hard.
To America.
It's so classic. Both of them in their own right. Okay, well, since Valentine's...
I mean, you're trying to compare a musical to a comedic classic.
That's true.
Yeah,
okay, well, since this is a more balanced comparison, since Valentine's Day is right around the corner, Love Jones or Love and Basketball?
Love Jones.
Okay, I have one for you, and it's going to be quite difficult, I hope.
Okay.
Steve Harvey or Rickey Smiley?
That's a great question.
I know.
But they're on the same time, so I can listen to both.
Okay.
No, that's not how you play the game, and you know how to play the game.
All in. I choose Rickey Smiley because he pays me.
Oh, well, there you go. That's very smart.
My partner.
Incredibly smart answer, and I love it.
I know. That was great. That was a great way to end this segment. Thank you so much.
I appreciate you.
And success with everything you're doing. Make sure you tell everybody where they can catch Man Cave.
Every Thursday, BT, 10:30 p.m. Eastern.
Okay, and where can we find more about you and all the stuff you're doing? Because you have 20,000 jobs like Steve Harvey.
Jeff's Nation is me on social media, and jeffsnation.com is my website. But they can always go to bt.com/mancave to find more about the show. And if they haven't seen it yet, to begin to see some of the clips. It's fantastic.
Well, tell the rest of the Man Cave to come on in. They're welcome here anytime.
Absolutely. I don't know about Slink, man. He might take your show.
No, take over, right? All right, Jeff Johnson, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much. We have a lot more still to come on Arise and Shame at 360. See you after the break.